All right, let's continue on with our analysis of yesterday's by-election wins for the Conservatives. Erin O'Toole is a conservative riding, a conservative MP for the riding of Durham. Whitby Oshawa's northern border is right on yours, and you sort of wrap around there. Yeah. And we were just saying before we came on, 2 years ago this November, you were fighting a by-election and won it. And there was similar sort of media buzz ahead of it that, oh, in this case, the NDP were making a surge and the Conservatives were threatened here. Bev Odeh was your predecessor, of course. But getting out there and fighting and doing all the right things, knocking on doors, organizing, and that's what Pat Perkins seems to have done in Whitby Oshawa to great success.
Absolutely. David, there's always a lot of speculation on where the 905 belt in Ontario mm-hmm. is. Are they strong supporters of Prime Minister Harper? And it's clear they are. You know, in my by-election 2 years ago, we had a strong and convincing win based on our record, which we have to run on. And we saw that last night with Pat Perkins. We have the best leader, the best candidate, and we worked the hardest in that riding. And you'll see we had a result that was almost equal to Jim Flaherty's 2008 result. So mm-hmm. this is a huge win. I know the Liberals are like spinning that they've tried to replace the NDP, but this is a really big win, pretty much 50% of the vote. And we have a two-term mayor, great candidate who stepped forward and was proud of the Conservative record, which speaks to our area.
And as we think of what was going on during this writ period, there wasn't a lot of voters, we should point out. Voter turnout was low, but that's pretty standard mm-hmm. for by-elections. So presumably those who voted had been paying attention to what's been going on in federal politics. Just before the writ, the Prime Minister was in the riding to announce the children's fitness tax credit is going to be doubled. Great news for parents. During the writ period, we see the fiscal update confirmed. We know income splitting and some other family benefits are going to be in the mix. Whitby Oshawa is one of these ridings that Justin Trudeau, it's a little more affluent, that Justin Trudeau is saying, well, these are affluent parents who don't need income splitting. Well, here we have voters for the first time got a chance to decide who's right on income splitting, Trudeau or the Prime Minister. A lot sided with Trudeau, but more sided with your side.
Absolutely. It was a great result. We were proud to run on that record. You know, the 905 has a lot of hardworking families with kids, much like that's my family. Mm-hmm. And what we've done, they like the fact we've balanced the budget, or we're getting to a balanced budget. That was always our primary goal by 2015. And we said there would be significant tax relief for families, so parents with children, once we got there. And so the announcement we made in Whitby on the Children's Fitness Tax Credit, doubling that, you know, the number of hockey teams in and around the 905 area, mm-hmm. my area of Clarington, Whitby, Oshawa, these parents are juggling all these things. They've seen costs go up on families, but wages go rise slowly. So we're trying to help out, and people seem to forget that we collect taxes, and when we get to a surplus, we should start giving some of it back. Mm-hmm. Mr. Trudeau wants to eliminate our tax cuts. So he clearly wants to take in more and spend more. And I think people clearly stated yesterday that they don't think that's the way forward.
Now, a win is a win. I mean, that the way our system is set up, first past the post, a win is a win, and that should really be the end of it. But people can take a look at these, say 15 or 16 by-elections since Trudeau and Mulcair have taken over. And while the Conservative record is excellent, just one loss, that was Peter Pinashaway up in Labrador, the percentage of people who are voting Conservative has dropped compared to 2011. Do you think there's any need to be concerned about that? In other words, the wins were not as big as the wins were in 2011 and in the by-elections we've had since.
I think part of that is the by-election phenomenon. It tends to be a move to you know, get groups to organize against the government, and we've mm-hmm. seen that. We actually have a better record.
Well, you had the unions organizing against you, I think.
Absolutely. The NDP put heavy emphasis on my riding and supported their candidate who had been an executive with the CAW. So you see that in by-elections, but I think we've won and maintained more of our seats than any other government in by-elections generally. But I think you're going to see in the gear up to the general election the real choice emerge, where you have Prime Minister Harper with a clear set of priorities, a track record of accomplishments, and what you see really is Justin Trudeau has moved the Liberal Party to the far left. That's where he's gaining his vote. You know, I have Liberals in my riding, David, coming up saying how uncomfortable they were with their position on ISIL. The mm-hmm. fact that Justin thinks we should give out parkas and Canada shouldn't play a role when there's ethnic cleansing and beheadings. Canadians have never taken that approach. We were at Remembrance Day. Our cenotaphs in small town Ontario had names on it because Canada was willing to stand up for principles and values alongside our allies, commensurate with our size. So Justin is, his strategy is to take away from Mulcair, and he's doing that by going left, saying he wants to tax. He'll talk Canadians into why they should forget about the tax cuts we're committed to. And, you know, you're seeing big government, big spending, and foreign policy positions that are also to the left.
Now, Justin Trudeau last night, I don't want to put words in his mouth. He said what he said, the trend is holding and all that. But my sense is they're excited because they have seen that party rebuild from some historic lows in 2011. I mean, they were in an awful place, the third party for the first time in their history. So they have been very much trying to supplant Thomas Mulcair and the NDP as the number one alternative, the number one threat to you guys. And it seems to me that you guys agree with that assessment, at the very least, that Trudeau and not Mulcair is the number one threat to the Prime Minister Harper next fall.
I think in some parts of the country you'll see the threat being the NDP. You know, some parts of Western Canada, Saskatchewan, British Columbia, even parts of Southern Ontario. The NDP
Quebec
did.
Quebec probably next.
Quebec as well. Yeah. The NDP came second in my by-election just 2 years ago, and the Liberals were still a distant third. But I think in other areas you are going to see the Liberals rebounding from historic lows. But as I said, I think their strategy has been to box out the NDP vote, the orange wave. By adopting positions on the left side of the spectrum. And I don't think for 905 Ontario, and we saw that yesterday in Whitby, Oshawa, that's not where the voters are. So Justin spent a lot of time in Whitby, you know, a half dozen appearances. He gave a speech on election night. If he likes this trend of them losing in Brandon, losing in Durham, losing in Whitby, I want to see that trend continue as well.
I'll bet you do. All right, Aaron O'Toole for the MP for Durham. Thanks so much for dropping in.
Thank you, David.